Let's not forget that this is not an African problem, an Asian problem. This is a problem of women, mothers, not getting the right care. The first Fistula hospital was set up in New York, the end of the 19th century. Immigrants were coming in, often poor, and they didn't have any access to healthcare, not at their home and not when they arrived in the US. At that time, Fistula was a problem that was around worldwide, because it's very simple. If patients don't get access to a timely C-section when the baby gets stuck and can't be born naturally, mothers and babies will die, but the mothers who survive might develop a fistula. The improvement of healthcare in the industrialized world, fistula was not longer a problem. The last patient with an obstetric fistula was operated in France in 1950. So a 100% preventable condition still existing in the poorer countries, that's unacceptable. And we can discuss a lot about how to improve our capacity to cure fistula, but we should much more discuss why they are still there. When a mother dies during childbirth, she's forgotten, for the world, not for her family, but for the world. But at least the patients who have survived, these are the patients we see with fistula, are the voice of those who have died. And as long as they are there, they are the witnesses of a poor health, poor functioning health system where mothers and babies are absolute no priority.